case you didn't notice, we are doing voter registration here tonight. And in case you didn't register on the way in, we play for about an hour and then we take a half an hour intermission, and you can go out there and take care of yourself during the intermission. Right? So get comfortable, sit down, we're gonna be here for a while. Alright? By the way, we are accepting donations of garments here. Not bad. This isn't exactly what we had in mind, but if you happen to have some pops. If you happen to have some ladies' underpants, brassieres, garter belts, things of that nature, as you can see, our, what, you want your shirt back? There you go. No, no, once is enough. We gotta go to work now. Gotta go to work now. The name of this song is The Black Page. Thank you. unspeakable, Ike Willis, Eric Buxton, Mike Keneally, Walt Fowler, Bruce Fowler, Paul Carmen, Albert Wayne, Kurt McGedrick, Chad Wackerman, Ed Mann, Robert Martin, Scott Tunis. And now a song about one of my favorite presidents called Dickie's Such an Asshole.
One and one is 11. Two and two is 22. Won't somebody kindly tell me what the government's trying to do? Dickie's just too tricky for a chump like me to use.
Even to this very day,
well,
to take that subcommittee serious, by you just might get a seizure from the evening news. Millions and millions of dollars, much as he might need. They can open up a chain of motels, people, on the highway, yes indeed.
Quadraphonic desperation, you know there'd be a cable all under your bed, on your bed.
Just might bring some wind in your slumber. The FBI kind of want to get your number.
Gonna get ya. Gonna get ya. Gonna jump out of the subcommittee and get ya. The FBI
wanna get your number.
The FBI
wanna get your number.
The FBI,
yeah, they want your number.
The FBI
and your picture too.
FBI,
they got a file on you.
FBI,
makes you wonder what they're gonna do.
FBI,
well, all that's done.
FBI,
they've been collecting about you.
Gonna get your number. Gonna get your number.
Worry, try not to care, but you know I get so delighted when a microphone's not there. Can't have no private conversations nowhere in the USA. The people all over the world find out that the government
is just the same old way every day. Thank you. tell you about this right here. To make this perfectly clear, let me tell you about this right here. You know you put me in office, so you must have wanted me in office. I did you no harm. I used to have 25 tapes, now I only got 10. Can't remember what happened to the rest, but I gave them to a friend. Gave a couple to B.B. Rebozo, gave a couple to Pat Boone, gave a couple to Ronald Reagan, gave a couple to the new vice president. He said he'd stick with me through thick and thin, even if I invaded Nicaragua. He said he wasn't gonna let him. You know I'm not a crook, you know I'm not a crook. I just wanna lie about one more thing right now.
Dance yourself right up. Kiss them all the dick goodbye.
Made him a cocksucker by proxy.
Yes, it did.
And it didn't even bat an eye.
The man in the White House.
Hey. He's got a conscience. Black as sin.
I don't know. It's just a training exercise.
There's just one thing I wanna do. How that asshole of a man is to get in.
Yeah.
You're all the same, so sing right along now.
Dick is us an asshole.
Sincerely, Dick, we mean it. Sincerely, Ron, we mean it. Sincerely, Dick and Ron, we continue to mean it. We ooh.
This is a song about the Union friends, how they fucked you over and the way they bend. The rules to suit a special few, and you get pooched every time they do.
You know we gotta stick together.
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 You know we gotta stick together. We gotta stick together.
We gotta stick together.
Once upon a time, the idea was good. If only they'd have done what they said they would. It ain't no better, at least making it worse. The labor movement's got the mafia curse. Don't you know we gotta stick together.
You know we gotta stick together.
You know we gotta stick together.
You know we
gotta stick together.
You know we gotta stick together.
You know we gotta stick together.
You know we gotta stick together.
Don't be no fool, don't be no dope. Common sense is your only hope. When the union tells you it's time to strike, tell the motherfucker to take a hike. You know we gotta stick together.
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 You know your mama and your daddy saying I'm no good for you. They call me dirty from the alley till I don't know what to do. I get so tired of sneaking around just to get to your back door. And your mama jumped out saying don't come back no more. I can't take it. My guitar wants to kill your mama. My guitar wants to kill your mama. My guitar wants to bring you back. I get real mean and it makes me mad. Later I try to call you. Your mama told me you weren't there.
You just weren't there.
She told me don't bother to call again. Yes, I cut off all my hair.
so tired of sneaking around just to get to your back door. I called as a daughter to your mama jumped out saying don't come back no more. I can't take it, but your dog wants to kill your mama. But your dog wants to kill your mama. Wants to burn your dad. Get real mean and it makes me mad.
Dental floss, raising it up.
waxing it down in a little white box. I could sell up town, but by myself I wouldn't have no boss, cause I'd be raising that lonely dental floss.
Raising the
just might throw me some bees, but I'd leave that sweet stuff to somebody else. But then on the other hand, I would keep the wax and melt it down, pluck the floss and swish it around, and I'd happily cry. And it'd be on top. That's why I'm moving to Montana.
To Montana soon, gonna be a dental floss tycoon. Moving to Montana soon, gonna be a dental floss tycoon.
Give me an old dental.
I am plucking the old dental floss. That's all another fairy plucking the floss. I pluck all day and all night and all afternoon. Well, I'm riding a small tiny horse. His name is Mighty Little, he's a good horse. He didn't know he's a ridiculous happy summer blanket on anyway. He's a ridiculous happy summer blanket on anyway. Anyway. I'm putting the old dental floss. Even if you think it's all silly folks, I don't care if you think it's silly folks. I don't care if you think it's silly folks.
Gonna find me a horse just about this big and ride that sucker all along the borderline with a very heavy duty found encrusted tweezers in my hand. Every other wrangler would say I was mighty grand.
It's mighty grand.
But by myself I wouldn't have no boss, cause I'd be raising that only dental floss.
Raising my
Well, I might ride along the border with my tweezers gleaming in the moonlight at night. And then I would get a cup of coffee and get my foot a push. Just me and the big pony over by the dental floss bush. And then I might just kind of sort of drop back on and ride like a dipshit into the north of Montana.
Moving to Montana soon. 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 Moving to Montana.
Yeah, those tiny auto horns.
somewhere. You can see it anytime when you get the squints from your downers and your wine.
You're so big, it's so tiny. Every cloud is silver lining. The great escape for all of you.
Tiny is as tiny do. Tiny is as tiny do. Tiny is as tiny do. Tiny is as tiny do.
Thank you.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, we don't normally do this, but just because this is St. Patrick's Day, and this is our special St. Patrick's Day program, and I even wore a green shirt and everything, we want to try and work a little bit of, well, let's just say, homegrown Irish flavor into this program. Now, bring the band on down behind me, boys. This is really quite technical. You understand that each ethnic group has characteristics, and these characteristics are generally made fun of by other ethnic groups. Now, I happen to feel that the Irish people in this country have gotten a bum rap, to use a common expression. Many people feel that Irish people in America simply aren't sexy. Take our president, for example. Now, in order to dispel the ethnic myth that people of the Irish persuasion are not particularly sexy, we are going to make it possible for volunteers from the audience tonight to demonstrate just how hot they are. Now, what I would like to have, I would like to have at least four girls who think they are Irish to come up here. No, they have to be volunteers. You have to volunteer for this. It can't be under duress. Let me explain. This is very scientific. We need two more. Okay. You all think you're Irish, right? Okay. Now listen, quiet please. This is very, very scientific. That's right. In order to prove that you are genuinely hot, we're going to give you, each and every one, an opportunity to make a sex noise with musical accompaniment. And so, here's the way, ready, gentlemen? You can be contestant number one. What I'll do is, after they give you the cue, you will make your particular sex noise, okay? One, two, three.
Make a sex noise!
Make a sex noise.
And rubber.
Make a sex noise.
Okay, sex the next contestant.
Sex noise. Make a sex noise. Say. Make a sex noise.
Make a sex noise.
Make a sex noise! Make a sex noise! Make a sex noise!
I'm not sure that each and every one of these contestants is truly Irish in the biblical sense of the word. But I think we have to give them credit for coming up here and representing the Irish people in Binghamton tonight. Especially when you realize that that's about the only form of safe sex left in America.
Everyone, make a sex noise.
make a sex noise. Make a sex noise. Make a Mexican sex noise. Thank you.
Today. Yeah. They got lies so big, they don't make a noise, they tell them so well, like a secret disease that makes you go numb.
with a big old lie and a flag and a pie and a mom and a Bible. Most folks are just liable to buy any lie, any place, any time. When the lie's so big,
it's just a training exercise.
As a Christmas case, that sinister face,
with my ammunition
behind all the Jesus around, could result in the end,
well,
to a worrisome trend, in which every American not born again could be punished in cruel and unusual ways. By this treacherous captain who tells everyone that when the lies get so big and the fog gets so thin and the facts disappear, the Republican trick can be played out again. People, please tell me when we'll be rid of these men. Just who do they really suppose that they are?
That's a local, ain't it?
And why do they manage to travel as far? As they seem to have gone.
Sing it, Ronnie.
Were we really that dark? People wake up, figure it out. Religious fanatics around and about the courthouse, the state house, the Congress, the White House, criminal saints with that heavenly mission,
just a training mission,
a nation in rapture. It's just a training mission.
Is everybody ready to go to Nicaragua?
Yes, give me your bars, give me your bars. I want to remember your history.
When the lie's so big and the fog's so thick and the facts get forgotten, the Republican trick can be played out again. People, please tell me when we'll be rid of these men.
Meanwhile, on the Honduran border,
there's a nothing little weasel about 3'9", face puffed up from crying and lying. Those are sweet little hubby sucking prom part time.
Ooh, him?
In the name of the Lord,
I get a clue, little shoe, oh yeah, oh yeah.
Jesus thinks you're a jerk, but he really choose Tammy to do his work. Oh no.
Come, smell the glove.
Robinson says that he's the one. Oh, he sure is, if Armageddon is your idea of family fun. And he's got some plan for you. Now tell me that ain't true.
My God. Do they really have these in the jungle?
Return to Managua. Now what if Jimbo's slightly gay? Will that let Jimbo get away? Everything we've heard him say indicates that Jim must pay.
It just might hurt a bit.
But keep that money rolling in, 'cause Pat and Baldy Jimbo can't get enough of it.
Let's go. Go, Timmy, go! Make a sex noise.
Ow, ah!
past, it's their idea of an affirmative action plan to give white trash a special break. Well, they took those diesel bucks and ran to the bank, to the bank, to the bank, to the bank. And every night you can hear them thank their body above for sending down his love while you all smell the love.
Tammy, isn't that an Irish kind of a name?
Jim and Pat should take a pull right up each saintly glory hole with tar and feathers too, just like they love to do to you. Cause they think you are bad, and they are very bad. Some folks don't want prayer in school. We need an art to survive the drool. A micro-publican's raised on hate. Jimbo Jumbo when they graduate. Convinced they are the chosen ones. And all their parents carry guns and hold them cards. Klux Mumu in the back of the truck. If you ain't born again, they wanna mess you up. Screaming no abortion, no siree. Life's too precious, can't you see? What's that hanging from a neighbor's tree? Why, it looks like colored folks to me. But they do that.
They've been doing it for years.
Seriously.
You know, I got a crazy idea. What if Pat gets in the White House?
Or even George Bush?
Oh, God.
Suddenly,
the rights of certain people disappear.
Mysteriously.
No.
Now, wouldn't that sort of qualify as an American tragedy?
If they cover it up,
saying, Jesus told it to me.
I hope we never see that day
in the land of the free, or someday will we.
You don't know by now the truth of what I'm telling you.
Then surely I have failed somehow. Surely I have failed somehow. Surely I have failed somehow. Those TV preachers make a monkey out of you. How?
I said, Jesus, don't think you're a jerk,
and it would be true.
There's an old rugged cross in the land of little Ronnie Reagan. In the Rose Garden Lawn,
and that asshole is still begging. Really? Tim and Tammy.
intermission, and you should get out there and register to vote, folks.
It's a Brazil.
Get this speech on how poor this might.
of a wealthy Florentine Fogan. Pow, 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 yeah, yeah, yeah.
could decide if you, if there is a really wanna know, is there anything? Could decide if you, if there is a really wanna know.
Is there anything good inside of you?
If there is, I really wanna know.
Is there anything good inside of you?
If there is, I really wanna know. Really wanna know.
Of the wrong kind.
Joseph.
Did a vehicle, did a vehicle fly along the mountains and find a place to park itself? Park itself.
Park it, park it.
Or did someone build a place to leave a space for such a thing to be?
Thank you.
The Indians from the Bill Cumber Hill.
Lucy, you've got me going on. the phony, but forgive me because I'm stoned.
Every time was kind of place where phony hippies meet.
Hey, dude.
Psychedelic Dutchies popping up on every street.
Go to San Francisco.
Hair is getting good in the back.
Say,
Berkeley Tom was down in the place before
me hit the street.
Hey, dude, psychedelic dungeons popping up on every street.
Move to San Francisco.
Gotcha. First, I'll buy some beads, and then perhaps a leather band to go around my head, some feathers and bells, and a book of Indian lore. I will ask the Chamber of Commerce how to get to Hate Street.
And they'll tell you Nicaragua.
Oh no, I'm smoking off a lot of dope.
I'm in Guatemala.
I will wander around barefoot. I will have a psychedelic gleam in my eye at all times.
But it's only a training exercise.
Nevertheless, Frank, I will love everyone.
With live ammunition.
I will love the police as they kick the shit out of me on the street. I will sleep. I will go to a house. I'll go to a house. That's what I will do. I will go to a house where there's a rock and roll band because the groups all live together. Yeah.
One pill makes you larger.
And one pill
and another pill you take it.
And another pill makes you go to Nicaragua.
But it's only a training exercise.
I will join the training exercise. I will be their road manager.
With live ammunition.
And I will stay there with them. And I will get my fucking head blown off, but I won't care.
Because I left my heart in Nicaragua.
Oh my God, wow! Let's try that one more time with no teeth. That's right. Now, I'm sure that you could all be singing the same tune in a few weeks as soon as that training exercise gets underway. So let's practice right now, folks.
No teeth, please.
It's only a training exercise. As you know, actually, after you fulfill all of the little qualifications of the training exercise, where do you think that will lead you? Huh?
That's more like it. Yeah, that's more like it.
Mr. President,
there's a lady who's sure all that glitters is gold.
Her
and
name
she's
is Nancy.
Buying the stairway to Nicaragua. And she gets there, she knows if the stores are all closed. With a word, she can get what she came for. Ooh, and she's buying the stairway to heaven. There's a sign on the wall, but she wants to be sure. Cause you know sometimes words have two meanings. In the tree by the brook, there's a songbird who sings. Sometimes all of our thoughts are misleading. There it goes again. Listen here. Ooh, it makes me wonder. And ooh, really makes me wonder. There's a feeling I get when I look to the west, and my spirit is crying for me. In my thoughts I have seen wings of smoke through the trees, and the voices of those who stand looking, looking. Ooh, makes me wonder.
Thank you.
Paul Carmen, Albert Winning, Kirby Gedrick, Chad Wagoner, Ed Mann, Larry Martin, Scott Tunis. Thanks for coming to the show. I'm delighted. Good night. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, I know that. This being St. Patrick's Day, a pseudo-religious holiday, I'm sure that you'll appreciate this pseudo-religious material we're going to bring you now. It's not really religion, it's make-believe television religion.
Jim once had a girl, or should we say, she once had he. She showed him her room, isn't it swell, Texas Motel. She told him to sit anywhere. So Jim looked around and he noticed there wasn't a prayer. Jim took off his rug, biding his time, pounding his pun. They prayed until two, and then she said,
how about some head?
Was booked in the morning, would fall well in hat. Jim told her he wasn't and dribbled some sprue in her lap. And when he awoke, he was alone.
She honed his comb.
So he let her fly, isn't it swell,
Texas Motel.
Ayo Silva! La 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 la.
Everybody!
La 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 la.
And then, just toward the end of the training exercise,
picture yourself with a whore from New Orleans, with big purple welts all over her body. Somebody calls and you answer quite slowly. It's the board from Assembly, oh God. Graveling on the old bed. Search for the girl with the spoon in her lap, and she's gone.
Louisiana hooker with her beast. Louisiana hooker with her beast. Louisiana hooker with her beast.
Where Jimmy gets off watching pornography. Everyone smiles as we tread through his horseshit.
that grows so incredibly high. Newspaper writers appear at his door, waiting to take Jim away. He climbs in the back with his head up his ass, and he's gone.
Louisiana hooker with herpes. Louisiana hooker with herpes. Louisiana hooker with herpes.
Ow! Picture yourself on your own TV station with brain dead supporters with tears in their eyes. Suddenly someone is there at commercial. It's the girl with the pee-hole surprise.
Louisiana hooker with herpes. Louisiana hooker with herpes.
Cause we're going to the Texas Motel. Don't mind the smell. It's nothing to get hung about. Please leave your cash on the table.
Weeping looks better with eyes closed. While I'm confessing all my sins. Oh. It's getting hard to prove someone, but it all works out.
It's all pornography to Jim. Let me take you down, cause we're going to the Texas Motel. We might go to hell. Of company for well and Pat and that weasel. No one knows who's in my tree.
Oliver North.
I mean, it must be high or low.
A mere pawn in a struggle between us.
I think it's just a training exercise, you know, but it's all wrong.
23 indictments, let's
that is, I think it's just an invasion. Let me take you down, cause we're going to the Texas Motel. Don't mind the smell. It's just some jizz from Jimmy Boy. How about some hay for the donkey? But you know I know, and it's a dream.
Welcome to Managua.
That is, I think I know. Oh yes, but it's all wrong.
The white zone is for loading.
That is, I think I disagree. Let me take you down, cause we're going to the Texas Motel. Don't mind the smell. It's just some old pornography. Just keep on stroking that sausage.
Just keep on stroking that sausage.
Jimmy boy.
Just keep on stroking that sausage. Yeah.
No!
arrest. And then the judge would have him for a special guest. The DA will order a secret test. The staff has pudgy little thongs in the side of his vest. Then they'll put out a call, "Hi, oh, Silver!" for the jury folks. And then the judge would say, "No invasion jokes." And dragging the paratroopers for all to see, saying, "Don't nobody conduct that exercise all over me. I'm Soapy Invasion in the first degree." And then the guys from Fort Ord might say,
"Why's everybody sending me down there?
Did you cause this mystery? Well, did you cause this mystery? Well, did you cause this mystery?" Elliot Abrams decided to shout,
"Oh, don't send no live ammo on me.
Abandon all your guilty. Tell me, what's your plea?" Another State Department spokesman shout,
"It's just a training exercise, can't you see?
Abandon all your guilty. Tell me, did you do these deeds?" You know what he said? He said, duh, turn the helicopter up, duh. And then he went, "I can't hear you, duh.
Just what they all need. It must be just what they told.
Birthday.